Hey guys, it's LNS here, and this time I'll bring you guys some Space Engineers gameplay, and I'm going to be making a new series for Space Engineers. I picked this game up a few days ago, and watched through some videos online, and there's a lot of things you can do in this game that is pretty damn crazy once you figure out some of the game mechanics. And over here, I have these two. I'm currently working on the different kinds of torpedoes that you can fire off. These kind of torpedoes are normally fired off large ships, such as the red one in front. And but I want to make a torpedo made of a large ship component, as you can see over here on the right, because they have the potential of using the gravity generators to be propelled by these gravitational generators. And the concept, I picked this up from a couple of YouTubers who are already doing it. They are the pioneers of the this kind of mechanics in this game, making use of the gravity generators in projectiles. A lot of possibilities, but never actually seen anyone using a smaller ship to fire a large ship missile like that. I'm still testing it. For the first episode, I'm gonna just show you guys what I've done so far. So these guys are my small ships. They're kind of like the tugboats, but I still haven't found a good way to have them be powerful enough to do the things I want them to do. So for example, let me show you guys over here. So I'm actually trying to power these two gravity torpedoes with potentially a small ship like that, but I'm still working on it because I can push it, but this ship will tip down because of the weight. So I'm trying my best to come up with a way to try and make up for that. So I have targets in front of me, four targets in front of me represented by the beacon. So first of all, I need to dock my small ship over here. I'm gonna try docking it over here. It's a really, really fun game, a lot of potential on what you can do. Alright, I can't seem to dock it to that, so I have to actually dock it and turn off the HUD. I actually have to dock it with my lower landing pads, which might be a bit of a trouble here because the momentum, you can see the ship is still moving even with my little tuck ship attached. I have some kind of control, a little bit of control, but not too much. As I said before, this is not as powerful as I want it to be. I might have to change the designs, but I'm getting there. So I locked it in place. This is how it looks like. Funny to see how such a small ship is able to hold in place such a big torpedo. So I'm just gonna change it a little bit more to make sure it's perfectly straight, because I need to compensate later when I'm moving forward. Alright, so I have the thing docked now. I'm also testing, working on how many gravity generators I have to have on the torpedo to make it as effective as possible. But I know when survival mode comes out, these gravity generators won't be cheap to make, so I want to make use of the limited resources I have to make this work. And thrusters also work on the missile itself, on the torpedo, but I'm just testing out the gravity based function. So I'm gonna actually put a rock over here so that this thing can actually take it. This is actually a really, really fun game if you guys are looking for something different. Alright, so I'm gonna drop a... Do I have stones? I have a stone, but it's not big enough to get captured by this apparently. So I'm gonna try it again. This is a little bit tricky. I might have to gather more stones. Try bumping it a little bit. Can I get it to... No, I need a bigger stone. So I need to go ahead and mine some more. Let's just hold up a little bit. I like all these small ships. Which gives me a lot. So I'm just gonna mine some stuff over here. With this guy. I'll be working on the fighters and potential larger ships, but for now I'm just working on the projectiles, such as the torpedoes, the different kind of torpedoes, different kind of warheads, and different kind of designs to give you guys a idea of how they might work in when multiplayer survival mode comes out, where we build large-ass ships and try to destroy it. So let's see if we have any, gather enough rock over here. Not much. Pretty sad. Looks like I have to gather a little bit more. Let's see. Find a new place to start mining. It's not kind of falling off. You can see from the bottom. Sorry about that. Alright, let me pull back a little bit to pick this, these rocks up. So I'm guessing in survival mode, to build a really large ship, you need all these raw materials that you get from mining. So pretty interesting. A little bit more over here. Hopefully it's enough to show you guys. 82 stone, let's hope it's enough. So here's another kind of projectiles I'm working on. But for now, I'm really interested in the gravity-based projectiles. So, gonna try it again. Hopefully this time it works. I have enough. It should work. Why is it not working? Let me try detaching this first. Landing pads doesn't require power, so it's not a problem when I leave it off. So let me try hitting it in. Come on. Should turn yellow. But it's not. I'm gonna try one last time mining more ores. By right it should work pretty well, but let's try again. Turn off the HUD. There you go, we have quite a good number of resources over here. Try to get 100. Yep, we have 100. To it again. Tell me what you guys think about this game, and it's actually really worth a buy. It's not the most expensive, 15 USD for a sandbox title with many features that will be implemented. Pretty worth. Alright, let's try that one again. It should work now. Why is it not working? Turn on the power to try it. Alright, if I have power, I'm gonna turn off the gravity generators. It's gonna be a pain to turn them on again. Off, everything off. I have 15 generators over here. Generators are off. Should be able to get this to work. It's not sticking. Right, let me try over here. Reason why it's not working. Alright, I'll try removing this and this and put in another one. There we go. No. Should work. Oh, come on. Have to be at the right position. Alright, let's try it again. Almost got it. Oh, come on. Oh. Oh, shit. Yay, it worked. Alright, but this is moving, so this is pretty bad. I have to stop it from drifting now. This is where this comes in. To hold the ship in place. There we go. It's small, but it's pretty strong. So now that this is in place, we shall actually do a test run. I'm actually gonna remove this. Oh, I actually can't remove that. I need to power on the generator. I need to power on the generators. But first let me line this ship up. Pretty damn hard to do it. As you can see. Hopefully get it correct. Looks good for now. Let's aim it a little bit lower. Still moving. Alright. Yeah, stop. And then I'm actually gonna power on the generators now. So fingers crossed. It will start moving as soon as I power these on. I should have a hotkey for us to group everything together so we can power it on at once. Alright, you can see that it's actually starting to move by itself. So I actually need to try and control this ship to the best of my abilities. You can see on the right, it's slowly accelerating. Alright, oh my god, bad time to save. I wish I'm gonna release it pretty early. So as you can see, it's still going. Powered by the gravity generators. It's a really good long range weapon because you can't see any thrusters coming out. Although it's pretty slow, but it will keep gaining speed and hopefully it hits a target. And because I used the small ship to launch it, the profile of this weapon system is very small. And you can see it's actually really powerful. It tore through a hole in this. And it's gonna keep going on forever, so it'll be very interesting to test it out on a ship. I'm actually gonna chase it because I want my rock back. God damn it! Come on, give me back my rock. No. Oh man, okay, I lost the rock. Forget it. Screw it. Okay, it'll keep going on. I need to find my ship. Where's my ship? So, pretty successful test there. And this first episode is gonna be a short one. But in the coming episodes, I'll test out the small ship launched torpedo, gravitational propelled torpedo. And this is actually a light armor, but it's a station armor. It's actually one thickness. So in the next coming stage, I will test it out again using the different thickness as well as the heavy armor as well to see how well they do. You can see that even though I didn't get a really fast speed on the torpedo over there, and considering I've maneuvered it using a really small ship, I think the test went pretty well, and I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'm going to be testing this one out in the next episode against a bigger target. And I'll be also changing some of the designs for my small ship like that. Pretty strong ship considering how small it is, and pretty maneuverable as well. Some light defenses, and yeah, I'll show the different variants as well. And yeah, I'll be covering a lot on the projectiles and torpedoes. And I'll be focusing more on the large ships at a later part of the series. So I hope you guys enjoyed this new series, and if you do like it, please subscribe and tell me in the comments below if you guys have any suggestions or feedbacks. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Take care guys. Bye.